Hello and welcome to yet another episode of Mechanic Basis Educational Videos. Today we're going to discuss one of the most important components in just about any car, and that is of course the oxygen sensor. The data this little part provides to our vehicles is essential for adjusting the air-fuel mixture. Predictably, any issues with it will cause all sorts of engine-related problems. However, diagnosing a faulty oxygen sensor is not that easy, as it doesn't necessarily have to trigger a check engine light. So, to help you with this, we will learn how the oxygen sensor works and, more importantly, how to spot a faulty one. But before we do continue, make sure to subscribe and hit that notification button to get all the latest updates from our channel. How does the oxygen sensor work? Before going over symptoms and common causes, let's first take a look at how the oxygen sensor works and what it actually does. The oxygen sensor was one of the earliest emission control devices fitted to a vehicle, and most cars since the 80s have at least one of them. Its job is to analyze the exhaust gases coming from the engine and examine their content. The information it provides is then used by the vehicle's computer, the ECU, to adjust the engine's air-fuel mixture and achieve optimum running performance. This, in effect, lowers fuel consumption, which consequently reduces emissions. The oxygen sensor in every car is located somewhere on the exhaust pipe or, in many cases, on the exhaust manifold itself, with its bottom end protruding into the piping. As the exhaust gases pass by, it determines the amount of oxygen in the gases and compares it with the outside air. The difference between the two generates voltage, which then serves as a signal to the ECU to adjust the air-fuel mixture and other running parameters. So, let's check how this looks in real life under the hood of a random vehicle. The oxygen sensor in every car will be mounted on its exhaust, just near the engine, as you can easily spot it here. In addition, most cars will have another sensor, called the downstream oxygen sensor. These are always located behind the catalytic converter. Still, the exact position of both these sensors will differ depending on the vehicle. And if you are having trouble finding them in your own car, go to our site and leave us a question. The link to our community forum is in the description. Symptoms of a faulty oxygen sensor. Having learned how the oxygen sensor works, we can now go over the symptoms that can give away a faulty one. First, there is a check engine light, which you will have on your dashboard if you're lucky. This means a corresponding error code will be stored in vehicle's memory, which you can then use to narrow down the problem. But this will not always be the case, so let's go over other symptoms you may also notice. The next thing is the fuel consumption. A faulty oxygen sensor will, in most cases, affect fuel consumption and cause poor gas mileage. This is because readings from this sensor are responsible for achieving optimum air-fuel mixture and consequent best possible performance. So, if you have noticed that you have to fill up more often with gas than before, the oxygen sensor is one of the first things to check. You could also notice black or excessive smoke coming from the exhaust pipe. Issues with the oxygen sensor will usually cause the engine to run rich, which effectively means it uses more fuel than it should. This excess gasoline will not get burned during the combustion process and will result in black smoke from the exhaust. You will likely notice puffs of it when accelerating or driving on full throttle. Next stop, you may have all sorts of performance issues. The ECU in your car relies on the data from the oxygen sensor to adjust things like fuel injection, ignition, or timing. If these values are incorrect, this will consequently cause all sorts of engine running issues and affect vehicle's performance in general. Symptoms you may be experiencing range from rough idle to hesitation and juddering that appear while accelerating. In worst cases, a faulty oxygen sensor could cause engine to misfire, which may damage it or the catalytic converter. Lastly, you could fail your emission test. A faulty oxygen sensor will offset the air-fuel mixture from its optimum balance, meaning the car could fail its emission test. Of course, this can be caused by many other things like a faulty catalytic converter or something similar. However, you should never rule out the oxygen sensor itself. The best idea is to get the readings from the exhaust analyzing machine, as these can tell a lot and help for further diagnosis. Common causes for oxygen sensor failure. Oxygen sensors are robust components that may last for more than 100,000 miles. But even under ideal running condition, a layer of carbon buildups will form on its surface, consequently offsetting its readings. Things that contribute to these buildups include unburned fuel and soot from the exhaust gases. In addition, unfavorable driving habits with frequent short trips only accelerate these processes. Using a low-quality fuel or one with lower than required octane value in a modern-day car can cause oxygen sensor issues, among other problems. With such gasoline, the combustion process will not be as efficient as it should, which consequently speeds up the formation of carbon buildups within the exhaust. But the good news is that in most cases, switching to a premium quality fuel will solve the issue. The oxygen sensor is effectively the first in line of fire inside the exhaust. And if the engine is burning too much oil, the sensor will quickly become coated with a thin oily layer. This will have the same effect as carbon buildups, as it offsets oxygen sensor readings. While cleaning or replacing the oiled-up sensor is a part of the solution, it won't help in the long run until the reason for increased oil consumption is not resolved. Inadequate and poor maintenance will harm many car components, with the oxygen sensor being one of the most affected. This is especially true if your car has been neglected for a long time or if its service history is unknown. Sometimes, performing an in-depth tune-up may help with the oxygen sensor issues. Lastly, the oxygen sensor itself, as well as its wiring and connector, may get damaged in several ways. In essence, this can be anything from mechanical force to dirt or corrosion buildups inside the connector. As you may imagine, this will interfere with sensor signals, causing all sorts of engine issues. How to deal with malfunctioning oxygen sensors? Several things may solve an oxygen sensor issue, depending on what is causing it. For a start, fix any broken wiring or loose connectors if there are any. Next, if the downstream oxygen sensor is covered with carbon or other buildups, you can always try to clean it. The best and easiest way of doing this is by leaving it to soak in gasoline for several hours. This simple method will dissolve dirt buildups that may have accumulated inside the sensor over the years. But while doing this, make sure the sensor's wiring is not submerged into the gasoline. Now, predictably, there is a question if the same can be done for the upstream oxygen sensor, which is the one before the catalytic converter. And although this is possible, it is really not highly recommended. As said, values from this sensor are critical for engine operation, and any improvisation here can result in further damage down the road. So, if the upstream oxygen sensor is faulty in any way, just replace it with a new one. This is definitely the best and most reliable solution.
So, there you have it. Now you should know everything about the oxygen sensor issues and how to fix the problem. If this video helped you with your own car, give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. But if it didn't, there might be something else causing the issue. To continue troubleshooting, visit our site, mechanicsbase.com, or check out our other videos on this YouTube channel.